Lo and behold, the horse turns into a prince who, except for the acquiescence of the hero, would have had to remain a miserable, shabby nag. I noticed something else about Christian Wolff's music. All you can do is suddenly listen in the same way that when you catch cold, all you can do is suddenly sneeze. Unfortunately, European harmony. Where it is, within us, but like an empty glass into which, at any moment, anything may be poured. Just something, finitely something, or even to be able to drink a glass of water. Unless some other idea crops up about it, that is all I have to say about structure. Characteristics he is transformed with respect to all of its characteristics. Music is an oversimplification of the situation we are actually in. An ear alone is not a being. Music is one part of theater. Focus is what aspects one's noticing. Theater is all the various things going on at the same time. I have noticed that music is liveliest for me when listening, for instance, doesn't distract me from seeing. One should take music very naturally. No technique at all. Only technique worth having. I remember being asked what I thought about technique. Time, which is the title of this piece, so many minutes, so many seconds, is what we and sound happen in, whether early or late. It is not a question of counting. Our poetry now is the realization that we possess nothing. Anything, therefore, is a delight since we do not possess it, and thus need not fear. This composition involves a flexible use of the number 10,000, that is to say 100 times 100 square root. The actual time lengths are changing. This work has no score, it should be abolished. A statement concerning the arts is no statement concerning the arts. It consists of single parts. Any of them may be played together or eliminated at any time. To me, teaching is an expedient, but I do not teach external signs. Like a long book, if a long book is like a mobile. The ignorant, because of their attachment to existence, sees unsignified or signifying. No beginning, no ending. Harmony, so-called, is a forced abstract vertical relation which blots out the spontaneous transmitting nature of each of the sounds forced into it. It is artificial and unrealistic. Form, then, is not something off in the distance in solitary confinement. It is right here, right now. Since it is something we say about past action, it is wise to drop it. I begin to hear the old sounds, the ones I had thought worn out by intellectualization. I begin to hear the old sounds as though they are not worn out. Silence, like music, is non-existent. There are always sounds. That is to say, if one is alive to hear them. Obviously, they are not. Whether I make them or not, there are always sounds to be heard, and all of them are excellent. We bake the cake. And it turns out that the sugar was not sugar, but salt. Are you deaf? The 12th tone row is a method. A method is a control of each single note, their development, the climax, the recapitulation, which is the belief one may own one's own home. There is too much there. There's not enough of nothing in it. So far, I have written two parts for a pianist. Either part can be played alone, or they can both be played together. Each piano is prepared differently, although as a matter of focus, the parts could be played without bothering to prepare the piano or pianos. If prepared, then, generally, the preparations will be altered in the course of the performance. The principle called mobility and immobility is this. Everything is changing, but while some things are changing, others are not. The The relationship of things happening at the same time is spontaneous and irresistible. It is you yourself that means the only thing that I do not find. The preparation of the pianos is also determined by chance. The various materials that exist are placed in the following categories. P meaning plastic, gold, glass, etc., and blue metal, C meaning cloth, fiber, rubber, W meaning wood, paper, etc., and other materials, etc. Coins are then forms not the same twice. Are also arranged. If it needed to be used, we are not using it in any other situation. These times are currently working with imperfection. I am thus able to definitely find certain aspects of the The sounds that have accidentally come to my ears were being heard, no sense of repetition. He simply thinks it was irritating. Irritating one way or another, that is to say, keeping us from ossifying. It may be objected that from this point of view, anything goes. Actually, anything does go. But only when nothing is taken as space, and in utter emptiness, anything can take place. The feeling we are getting, no, that is a pressure, which will continue. Why? The way who hide that your ears send the message of surprise and perplexity. That's the way. Exactly. What is the difference between men or men and mountains or mountains before studying Zen and men or men and mountains or mountains after studying Zen? It is not a question of going into oneself or out of the world. It's rather a condition of the Zen that's taken out. Need I quote Blake? Certainly not. Spots are spots, the skills needed to turn them to the point of practicality. Tape music requires multiple loud speakers. But those features, formerly for me, time length was a constant. Now it too, like everything else, changes. Changing in contemporary music. Unfortunately, European thinking has brought it about that actual things that happen, such as suddenly listening or suddenly sneezing, are not considered profound. Not just tones, voices too. What is the physical action involved in playing an instrument? Yes! For instance, now my focus involves very little, a lecture on music. My music. But it is not a lecture, nor is it music. It is, of necessity, theater. What else? If I choose, as I do, music, I get theater. That is, I get that. Not just this, the two. Art is order, expression, or integration of these. It is the light the Chinese say, but there is darkness. What is now unheard of is an 8 loudspeaker situation. To be in the center of transmission, sounds coming from every direction. After 8 can be 16. Where is the best position for audition? The corner where you are. It is understood that everything is clean, there is no dirt. Then why are you always taking baths? Just a dip. No, why? For me, it is a matter of getting up and daily, unless commitments. That is finished now. It was a pleasure. And now... just the same, only somewhat as though you had your feet a little off the ground. Now, at the beginning, before studying music, men are men and sounds are sounds. But this causes some hesitation on the hero's part, but he finally acquiesces. One of them said he must have lost his favorite animal. Another man said, no, it must be his friend. Do you only take the position of doing nothing and things will, of themselves, become transformed? Think for a moment about sound, how it has pitch, loudness, timbre, duration, and how silence, which is its non-existent opposite, only has duration. Duration, structure. Error is drawing a straight line between anticipation of what should happen and what actually happens. What actually happens is, however, not a total linear situation and is responsible generally. Therefore, error is a fiction, has no reality in fact. Errorless music is written by not giving a thought to cause and effect. Any other kind of music always has mistakes in it. In other words, there is no split between spirit and matter. And to realize this, one has only suddenly to awake to the fact. This makes possible for writing of such durations as 1/7 plus 1/3 plus 3/5, all fractions of a quarter. This brings about an emphasis on uniqueness, so that two nearly the same durations can each be uniquely itself, just as two leaves, however much of the same tree, are not identical. If there is time, privileged tones that remain are arranged in modes or scales or nowadays rows, and an abstract process begins called composition. Express. In the direct situation, it is. If you don't like it, you may choose to avoid it. But what silence requires isn't it. What I think and what I feel can be my inspiration, but it is then also my pair of blinders. To see, one must go beyond the imagination, and for that one must stand absolutely still, as though in the center of a leap. Several stories occur to me that I should like to interpolate in the same way, by the way, that while I'm talking, the telephone keeps ringing, and then contemporary conversation takes place. Instead of this particular way of preparing a lecture, it is high and low. Has a certain timbre, and loudness. I will not disturb by my concern the structure of anything that is going to be acting. To act is a miracle and needs everything and every need out of the way. An error is simply failure to adjust immediately from a preconception to an actuality. However, it occurs to me to say more about structure. Specifically this, we are now at the beginning. Or not. And it isn't a human being or something to look at. It is high or low, has a certain timbre and loudness, lasts a certain length of time. And it is necessary to see that there is not only a sharp distinction to be made between composing and listening, but that although all things are different, it is not their differences which are to be our concern, but rather their uniqueness and their infinite play of interpenetration with themselves and with us. There are three categories of noises in the two parts for two pianists. Those produced inside the piano construction, outside the same, and accessory noises, whistles, percussions, etc. Writing music is for musicologists. There is no straight line to be drawn between notes and sounds. Theater takes place all the time wherever one is, and art simply facilitates persuading when this is the case, so that this ignorance I speak of is not losing sensitivic responsiveness. On the contrary, it is a question of when, now. Flees she up or flees she down? It acts in such a way that one can hear through a piece of music, just as one can see through. Echoes breaking variant speed and synchronized. Skillful means has a good deal to do with multiple division of process. And here, for instance, we begin to be in a state of immobility. Anyone can see the desire of mobility. Had I had nothing to say, it would have been different. All it is what it is, faster and slower. It is the space between the loudspeakers that is to be considered. From a desire for clarity, great. Is it interesting? It is. And it isn't. But one thing is certain. They are, with respect to counterpoint, melody, harmony, rhythm, and any other musical methods, pointless. All that is necessary is an empty space of time and letting it act in its magnetic way. Eventually, there will be so much in it that whistles. In order to apply to all these various characteristics, he necessarily reduces it to numbers. He has also found a mathematical way of making a correspondence between rows. I remember as a child loving all the sounds, even the unprepared ones. I liked them especially when itself in the jaws, cheeks, and tongue, and the commentary says, the most superficial way of trying to influence others is through talk that has nothing real behind it. The influence produced by such mere tongue wagging must necessarily remain insignificant. I believe that one can arrive at directing the phenomenon of the automatism of chance, which I mistrust as a facility which is not absolutely necessary. For, in the end, in interpolations and interferences between different rows, when one of them passes from timings to pitches, and at the same time that another passes from intensities to attacks, etc., there is already a sufficiency of the unknown. Diminishes his love and increases his fear about what other people will think. There is all the time in the world for studying music. But for living, there is scarcely any time at all. For living takes place each instant. Unimpeded. There are two great dangers for magnetic tape. One is music, all the history and thinking about it, and the other is feeling obliged to have an instrument. One is Pacific 231, 1954, and the other, organ music. If you are interested, you can read a detailed description of it. Each one of us is thinking his own thoughts, his own experience, and each experience is changing. And while we are thinking, to get yourself in such a state of confusion that you think that a sound is not something to hear but rather something to look at, I am happy about all the experiences I have had with the prepared piano. For one thing, it showed me how different two pianos are from one another, and music, so-called, makes us think two pianos are the same. It isn't true. It is tossed out. It just happened that the series of numbers, which are the basis of this work, add up to 100 times 100, which is 10,000. That is pleasing momentarily, the world, the 10,000 things. But the title is simply minutes and seconds. Question asked you, how do you need to cautiously proceed in dualistic terms? A, B. Just as going from here to Egypt is a single trip, but a more or less complex series of experiences, or just as Chinese characters are some written with one stroke, but others with two, or several, or many, and not in the way we need for living. For instance, someone said art should come from overhead. There was a social calendar and hours for breakfast, but one day I saw a cardinal, and the same day I heard a woodpecker. I also met Meister Eckhart. Of course, Kansas, Arizona is more interesting. I have nothing to say, and I am saying it, and that is poetry. It is no longer a case of moving along. Stepping stones, scales of any degree, series of no matter what, but one can move or just appear to at any point in this total space long enough to see the end of this craze for Bach. A pupil once said to me, I understand what you say about Beethoven, and I think I agree, but I have a very serious question to ask you. How do you feel about Bach? Now we have come to the end of the part about structure. That two or more things happen at the same time is... It is entirely possible for something to, their relationship, synchronicity, that break, for instance, meets at the center moving out in all directions, and then time is clearly, should one stop and mend it? Luminous. It could not be easily otherwise. Go wrong, and machines are never synchronous, not even the synchronous ones. If you need several things at once, use one as the basis and one motor. To be and be the present. Would it be a repetition? Only if we thought we owned it, but since we don't, it is free and so are we. Most anybody knows about the future and how uncertain it is. A sound is a sound. To realize this, one has to put a stop to studying music. The most enlightening thing about magnetic tape is this. Whether we actually do it or not, everything we do say what we're doing is affected radically by it. Rhythm is not arithmetic. And so is this unfinished work. So far, for two pianists, string players, lecturer, lines of demarcation are okay. When they have to do with potentiality, it must be clearly understood that they have nothing. A sound accomplishes nothing. Without it, life would not last out the instant. It is only irritating to think one would like to be somewhere else. Here we are, now. Eventually, everything will be happening at once. Nothing behind a screen unless a screen happens to be in front. It will increasingly be a thump instead of a bang. The thing to do is to gather up one's ability to respond and go on at varying speeds, following, of course, the general outlines of the Christian life. I myself tend to think of catching trains more than Christianity. Insisting on stimulating activity, though. Without a multiple loudspeaker system, all becomes music and submissiveness. But fortunately, the piano is there, and one can always prepare it in a different way. Otherwise, it would become an instrument. It is like, Artaud said, a disease, no avoiding and not having an idea about it. The thing to do is to keep the head alert, but empty. Things come to pass, arising and disappearing. There can then be no consideration of error. Things are always going wrong. We're apt never to know. But something else is happening. I am getting nowhere slowly as the talk goes on slowly. We have the feeling we're getting nowhere. That is a pleasure which will continue if we are irritated with whatever. This goes to explain what he means when he says that he is associated with all the sounds and so can foresee what will happen even though he has not written the particular notes down at room temperature as other composers do. And I have noticed something else about almost anyone's music that can be accomplished to increase the unpredictability already inherent in the situation. The control must be at one point only and so placed that it has no effect on anything that happens, technique which results in no technique, etc. Of course the answer is time, and since we have them, chronometers, I mean, use them, or you may leave it forever and never return. Play my piece for bells, whether I hear it or not, is of no consequence, but until someone does, music is at a standstill. Before I die, I shall leave a will, because if you want something done, sentimentality is effective. I haven't the slightest idea of what is good in the world, but instead quite passively and often against what might be considered a better judgment, accepts what happens. It's self-changing in a changing, sonorous environment. The way it does it is by the intimacy of multiplicity and emptiness. The mind has nothing in it, but everything else is busy, and there is not an instant lost in doing what must be done. Later on, if you wish, you can read about mobility and immobility. To repeat, I am no longer interested in it. I am interested in asymmetry. If one feels protective about the word music, protect it and find another word for all the rest that enters through the ears. It's a waste of time to trouble oneself with words, noises. What it is theater, and we are in it, and like it, making it.